I'm actually optimistic about the outcome of the coronavirus crisis. Of course, there's a tragic part to this. People are losing loved ones, and there are no words that can compensate or manifest the kind of sorrow and sadness and pain that these people are feeling. So the tragic element in terms of loss of life and the damage to the economy and loss of jobs and the disruption that has happened is of global magnitude. But despite of that reality, I'm still optimistic. This is actually a crisis. It's a global crisis, but still it's a crisis. And the definition of a crisis is that it is an interruption to the normalcy of life. This is not an existential danger. Just imagine if the fatality rate of this epidemic was 80 or 90%, and if it was faster in spreading. Imagine if this was targeting kids as well. It could have been much worse, and the outcome would have been dramatic. The end result would have been dramatic. Colossal state. But the way it is now, it appears to be a crisis that we will eventually overcome. And the damage, although severe and painful to some more than others, will be contained and life will go back to its normal state. So the second point that makes me optimistic is that I believe we will come out of this more informed, smarter, and wiser. The amount of research and experimentation and thinking that is going into dealing with this crisis is huge, and it's happening everywhere. And I believe this is helping us in reshaping our thinking when it comes to these kinds of global health challenges. So I think that at the end of this, our readiness to become more prepared for future possible such outbreaks will be much higher. And it is almost certain that there will be such outbreaks in the future. This is a fact of reality. This is how nature operates. From time to time, there are such outbreaks. It has happened before, it's happening now, and it will continue to happen afterwards. So this one is helping us to learn how to become more prepared for the next one that might be bigger than the coronavirus danger. And this is not only a human being challenge. These occurrences of these viruses happen all the time, and sometimes they affect other kind of creatures. We don't feel that. What I'm saying is that this is part of reality that will, in the end, the way we're handling it will manifest itself in more experience in dealing with this aspect of nature. I feel that this is serving to become a strong wake-up call to what it really means to become one global connected community. We have been talking about this for a long time, but mainly in an intellectual way. Now, we can feel it. Every single person on the planet can feel what it means to be really connected. What it means that a virus that appeared in one corner of the planet in a few months or maybe a few weeks' time will have effects, dramatic effects, on the other side of the planet. So now we appreciate more what it means to be a connected global community. This is increasing our sense of responsibility. Now, because of what happened and because of the way this is transforming and this is moving across societies and people and individuals and even countries, is increasing our sense of responsibility. People are feeling more responsible. And this is a beautiful thing. The more we have this sense of responsibility, the better our life, the quality of our life will be. And that brings us to number 5. as a reason of optimism. And this is the fact that we really matter. You and I as individuals matter. And we're seeing that every day. If somebody is infected by coronavirus and doesn't take the right precautions and is reckless, the implications of that recklessness of that individual might be affecting dozens, if not hundreds, of other people. So this is a striking example to each of us that regardless how you and I think of ourselves, and maybe sometimes often we're not appreciative of ourselves. We think that we're not worthy. We think that we mean nothing. But what's happening is showing that no, you mean something. If you make good decisions, you matter, because the good decisions impact other people. If you made bad decisions, you also matter, because your bad decision will impact other people. So this has highlighted the importance of the individual as a person. It has also highlighted the importance of collective behavior. There is absolutely no way that we could handle such an epidemic if it was up to individuals. It will take collective individual work to come up with an antidote to this virus. It will take collective individual work to come up with a treatment in the future. It is taking collective work to take the necessary precautions and contain this. So we've discovered that we matter individually and we matter collectively. We have learned to take more care of ourselves. We need to take better care of ourselves. We're learning this the hard way. If you don't take care of yourself, then you will end up in trouble. If you don't take care of each other, we'll also end up in trouble. So this is also an additional good outcome that is coming out of the coronavirus crisis. That is, we're learning the importance of not neglecting ourselves individually and not neglecting each other. And this is a good thing. Number 7, we're appreciating more good leadership, because it will take good leadership to come out of this. We have seen this in some countries more than others, how because of good leadership, because of effective leadership, because of conscientious leadership, societies have managed to contain the damage of the coronavirus and to gradually start the journey of overcoming it. And from that we can derive the possible impact of bad leadership. And we can see from other examples how in cases where leadership neglected, the authorities neglected, you know, the reality and took it lightly and failed to exercise proper leadership. And as a result of that, as a consequence, their societies end up paying unnecessary damage, because had they paid more attention in the past, they would have saved their societies huge economic and personal costs. So this coronavirus crisis has taught us about the importance of developing, cultivating, choosing leadership that can be up to these kinds of challenges. Number 8, coronavirus crisis is teaching us also how to improve our local and global healthcare systems. Everywhere in the world, healthcare system at the smallest level and the largest level are upgrading themselves with knowledge, with equipment, with new kind of protocols. So I expect, logically speaking, that by the end of this crisis, even if it took several months, maybe a little more, the world will end up more informed in terms of how to design protocols that could deal with these kinds of epidemics. So our healthcare system will end up becoming more efficient, more productive, smarter. And the implications of that are our health system will become better, and the readiness, the preparedness for future such epidemics will be higher. This virus is teaching us to become more humble. I want to let's reflect on this. This is a microscopic scale virus. One single virus of microscopic scale has led to the fact that entire humanity is brought to a standstill. Hundreds of billions, possibly trillions of dollars will be lost because of this one microscopic virus. This virus doesn't have technology that we have, doesn't have the brain power that we have, doesn't have the intellectual capacity that we have, doesn't have this wealth of knowledge and history, civilization, culture that we have. It's just a small virus, and it has led to paralyze and put on alert entire human race. So it's a good example, it's a good wake-up call to understand that despite of all what we can do, all our capacities, intellectual, you know, technological, economic, military, you name it, one virus has the potential to put our entire human existence at stake. And in that, there is a great lesson of being humble. Number 10 is renewed faith in human creative abilities, in the miracle, in the genius of being human. Because just observe how human beings are coming together to solve this problem. As I said, these kind of outbreaks doesn't only happen to human beings. It happens in a way that affects also other parts, other aspects of nature, other kinds of animals. But we are the only species that can come in matters of weeks or months together, put all our problem-solving ability, all our creative abilities, all our genius together, work collectively, maybe not in a perfect way, but in absolutely beautiful way, to come up with a solution and to share this solution for the best interest, for the benefit of mankind everywhere. And this is a source of hope. It is true that as human beings we have been doing serious errors, especially when it comes to the way we treat nature and the way we treat each other. And there's lots of reason to be upset about this aspect of our being. But at the same time, to be fair, let's look at the bright side. It's a wonderful thing to be part of the human race, because we could do all of this together. And the way we're going to solve this problem is going to give us hope that we will solve other future problems, and we will overcome them, and we will learn from them, I hope. And sooner or later, this coronavirus, although very painful to many than others, will become memory. And eventually, life will continue, and we'll be better. And that's the reason for my optimism.